Hi guys, how you doing? This is just a quick video on like progress and how to sort of measure it or how to define it, really. I've had a couple of emails this week from a few people. One from a new like who's just started 7 weeks ago. One from who's just done, this is their second boot camp, and one who's done a couple of boot camps. And it's just interesting because everyone's got slightly different like progress sort of markers and reports, and it's just quite interesting because I know that one of the difficult things to maybe do is appreciate your progress and understand what it is and how it manifests, because progress is not just about aesthetic looks and losing inches. The tricky thing is, like, because there's so many people at the bootcamp, everyone's like got different like perspectives on what their progress should be. And when I'm making this video and you're watching it, like, depending on who you are, like, it's different things are going to be relative to you. So there's some folk that are maybe got a lot of body fat to lose. They feel that their main thing is they think, well, I know I'm overweight, and I know that it's something that's obvious that needs to come down. So what you tend to assume is that those folk will be the ones that will be more likely to use weight as a marker of progress. Again, in the first 6 weeks especially, regardless of your start point, I don't think that weight loss is one of the best ways to go about it. You're monitoring your progress regardless of how much weight you've got to lose, because you will offset a wee bit of weight loss with muscle gain. But looking a bit further down the line, like maybe 12 weeks, 16 weeks, 20 weeks, that kind of thing, 6 months, those that have a lot of body fat to lose should be seeing the weight come down. So it's I'm not saying, like, obviously I say ditch scales, don't monitor progress by weight, and that is fundamentally what I believe, but that doesn't mean to say that weight's like irrelevant, and especially if you do have a lot of weight to lose, because it means if you lose body fat, you will start to lose weight in time. For example, there was someone that sort of asked recently, like, they've started 7 weeks ago and they've not noticed any aesthetic changes yet, but unless you've got a lot of body fat to lose, you're not going to notice a lot of aesthetic changes in 7 weeks, especially if, for example, you're just doing 3 sessions a week. That's only 3 hours of exercise a week, which isn't very much, really. But specifically the type of exercise you're doing, it's intense training, so it takes time for the body to adapt. You're doing strength and conditioning work here, so it's important that you try and understand the concept of the type of approach we're trying to take with you. It's not a typical diet approach whereby the fundamental guideline for progress is the weight and the scales and the inches lost, because you go to a diet club every week and you weigh yourself or you check your inches and you note them down. So fundamentally that is how diet clubs work. This isn't what this is. This is a performance-based athletics bootcamp, and that's why we say focus on the performance and the aesthetics will come. And you need to try and put your progress in perspective. So I did a very quick calculation here, right? So for example, right, I'm 31. So let's suppose you're my age or even older than me, right? And you've only just started changing your eating habits 7 weeks ago. So you've started focusing more on protein intake, and you've started working with weights and trying to improve the way you can hold your body and work your core in a certain way. Let's suppose you only started doing that 7 weeks ago. So if you are 30, now this is based on the age of 30, 7 weeks of this sort of training represents 0.44% of your life, like, unless I'm doing the math wrong, which is very possible, by the way, but I've worked it out that 7 weeks of 30 years on Earth is less than 1% of your life's existence on Earth. If you put it, and that's if you're 30, so if you're more than 30, then the percentage of your is even less. So you can't expect, nor do you deserve, really, to make aesthetic changes that quickly. And I think sometimes if you work from the, if you take it back the way and look back on it, look at it in reverse, it might start to make more sense. So for example, I'm 31, I've been training pretty much all my life, so that's maybe 75%. Or something like that of my life, in terms of how frequently I've trained or how often or how many weeks out of my life I've probably trained, but 75% of them, which is a huge difference between that and 0.4%. Now that's not to put you off and say So you're screwed because you're going to have to wait 10 years before you see progress. Of course not. But what I'm trying to say is you need to have patience and appreciate that the changes that you're going to achieve are going to take more time. Okay. So progress, first of all, is just doing the sessions, getting through them, and trying to focus on improving your performance on them. That is progress in itself. Progress is being more consciously aware of the foods you're consuming. It's not just all about eating less calories in your burn, it's about the type of calories that you're consuming. Focusing more on the protein, trying to get consistent with that. Eliminating cravings. If you're very overweight, it means it's because you overeat. And if you overeat, it's usually because you get cravings to keep eating, or obviously there's other things attached to that. It's emotional attachments, eating out of adversity to certain situations. I know all that is part of it. But if you're finding that you find it hard to control, you need to find mechanisms to try and get it under control. And that's why the protein consumption is important in that respect. So these are all goals. So in other words, if you are finding that you're eating plenty of more nutritious food, you're eating plenty of protein to the point where you're thinking, actually, I'm not getting cravings anymore. I feel in control. I'm not getting those hunger pangs I always get. That is progress. Even, remember in the early weeks, I often say that it's sometimes good to, it doesn't matter. Don't worry too much if you're overeating initially. If it turns out or it transpires that even though you're focusing on plenty of protein and vegetables and things, if it transpires that you're overeating a wee bit and that's why you're not making any inches lost or weight loss or whatever, that's not a bad thing. There's nothing wrong with that because that will do two things. If you're overeating inadvertently by accident, even though you're eating more protein and things, if you're overeating in the first few weeks, what it does do is it at least ensures that you're fueling your body and you're getting plenty of energy for the sessions. So you're not going to be at risk of, or you're going to be at less risk of like crashing at sessions and feeling lousy. So remember, first and foremost, we're trying to make you feel better, physically and more energetic and more by nourishing your body. That's all. That's whole point in vitamins and minerals is because they nourish your body, so they make you feel better. They make you feel more energetic. So that's one benefit of inadvertently overeating, even if it's in good food, overeating in the first few weeks and not making progress. And the second benefit of inadvertently overeating, which is that it means there's now loads of room for manoeuvre. So let's suppose you change your approach and you went back to an old school approach or a really quick, rapid weight loss approach and you did the soup diet. So let's say you went in the soup diet, right? By this point in time, you would have definitely lost a ton loads of weight, but you'd also feel very lethargic. You'd struggle through the sessions to the point you'd probably have to quit half of them. You would probably lose muscle mass, so you wouldn't be building on the one thing we're trying to focus on, which is building more muscle to increase your metabolism, amongst other things in terms of shaping your body and all that. So you would have achieved, you would maybe be satisfied on a superficial level because you'll have seen inches come down or you've seen weight loss achieved. But in 6 months from now, that's unsustainable, so you're going to get ill and then you'll definitely rebound. So the good thing about actually, even if you are overeating at the moment on good food, right, if you are inadvertently overeating on good food, the great thing is you then just need to start eating a wee bit less and suddenly magic will happen. Now that has happened quite a few times to great effect. Like you build up the amount of food you're eating, fueling your body, you get to the 8 week mark, 9 week mark, 10 week mark, and you're thinking, right, I'm getting stronger, but I'm actually not making any, I've not lost 10 inches or whatever. So all you need to do then is eat less. But that only refers to folk that have got a lot of inches to lose. Some folk don't. Some folk just need to focus on like improving their performance and the body shape will become more athletic in time. I don't really like talking about all the aesthetic side of it like this, but at the same time, I understand that that's what people are really a lot of the time focused on. Like, even though we're saying try not to focus on it, focus on performance. An example of focusing on the performance and the aesthetics would be that one-legged deadlift exercise you did. So the reason that was very difficult, okay, as I explained in a wee Facebook post, the reason that was very difficult is because as soon as you go into one leg to perform that movement, all the stabilizer muscles in the hips have to work really hard to keep your hips stable. Okay, so the hip stabilizer muscles are pretty much the majority of the muscles around the glute complex, like the TFL, the glute medius, the glute minimus, the abductors. There's various other smaller muscles, but basically most of the muscles around the glute complex are responsible for helping to stabilize your hips. So that's why it, that's one reason why your backside feels so sore the next day. But the reason is if you become really good at that exercise, i.e. if you improve your performance of that exercise, it's indicative of the fact that those muscles around your glutes are now firing very well and that they're stronger. And as a result, over time, if you continually put them under stress and duress, those muscles will have to adapt. And by adapting, they'll start to develop. As a result, they'll change shape aesthetically. But you're not focusing on trying to improve the aesthetics of those glute muscles. You're trying to improve the function of them. You're trying to become more stable through the hip. And it just so, and in time, a byproduct of that is improved aesthetics. If that, hopefully that makes sense. That's an example of focusing on the performance and the aesthetics will come. So in other words, if I see someone who's about to perform that exercise and they've got really well-developed glutes, I know before they're going to perform it that they're going to perform it pretty well because all the muscles around their glutes are well-developed, so they'll have good stability in their hips. So that's an example of that. So progress takes many forms. It takes time. Okay, you can't rush it. You need to focus on getting stronger, getting a stronger core, developing those muscles, stronger in the legs, developing those muscles. And the stronger those muscles all become, eventually the body will respond by developing the muscle tissue, and then it will shape it and it will mould it. Then the missing link after that is to ensure that you're eating enough to elicit a loss of body fat. If you have a lot of body fat to lose, if you don't have a lot of body fat to lose, you'll just find that in time your shape will just become more athletic anyway, because the muscles will mould. But if you're wanting to elicit fat loss, then you need to make sure you're also eating less. But at the same time, you must maintain a high level of protein intake. So 2 grams per kilo of protein, as you know, is a target. You could go up to 2.5. You could even go up to 3 grams, and there's definitely no negative side effects of that. In fact, recent studies by a guy called Jose Antonio would suggest that 3 shows some very promising signs for fat loss. And I'm going to attach the study that's been summarised really well by a guy called was it Brad Dieter? Funny name, quite a not a funny name, a appropriate name, Brad Dieter, or maybe it's Dieter. He summarised it really well and explains all that. So I'm going to attach it to this video. So you, regardless of whether you're trying to like lose fat or build muscle, it's really important that you maintain the protein intake so that you don't lose muscle tissue, okay? And you also, it will mean that when you're trying to lose fat, one of the challenges is to overcome cravings. So as you know, the protein is more satiating, so it will keep you fuller and it will keep you less likely to get cravings, even when you're trying to lose body fat. So that's, I'm trying to summarize it as quickly as I can. It's only 15 minutes, this video, but there's various milestones. You need to have patience, focus. I think most newbies should forget about inch loss for the first whole block. This is 16 weeks long. I would forget about it. At the same time, though, if you get to maybe the 12-week mark, right, and you are convinced you're doing everything you should be doing, that's when it's more than likely that although you're eating well, you're probably just eating a wee bit too much. And the beauty of that is, all you need to do is start eating a wee bit less. Just less, make your portions a wee bit smaller. Have 2 eggs instead of 3, maybe. Have less food generally, just have a wee bit less. It doesn't need to be a massive amount. In fact, it shouldn't be a massive amount, but just subtly bring it down, you know, and you will definitely elicit a response if that's what the problem is. So to be patient, I recommend that you speak to people that have been in your position. So people that have done 2 or 3 boot camps now understand the whole concept of how that it takes time, because after they've got through that first phase, they realise that things start to happen after that. I've only got a minute left. I was going to quickly touch upon another 2 people emailed me. So one of the girls, this is her 3rd boot camp now, she lost a stone after 1 boot camp. She's quite a bit of body fat, so she lost a stone. She's since lost 0 pounds, zero, but she's dropped another 2 dress sizes without any weight loss. Now, someone asked me, how is that possible? The truth is, right, it's not entirely clear why it all happens like that. I don't know the answer. All I know is the body's a funny thing. I now weigh 90 kilos. I have no idea why I weigh 90 kilos, because for most of the last 2 years, I've weighed 84 kilos, and I've now probably eaten less than I did. I'm stronger than I am, I'm leaner than I am, and I'm putting on weight. I don't know why. I honestly don't know why. So sometimes these things just happen. Yes, muscle mass can offset fat loss, but not there's sometimes there's no explanation for what's going on with your weight. Water can manipulate things, like hormones can manipulate things. There's various things that could be to blame, or can result. But anyway, I'll maybe make another video because that's time.